The topic that we spend more time on in an algebra class, probably more than any other topic, is the study of different types of equations. And there's a lot of them. There's a lot of different types of equations, like linear equations we're going to talk about in this video, and also quadratic equations we'll talk about later in the semester, and rational equations and trigonometric equations, and on they go. But we usually start with linear equations because they're the easiest to understand and probably the smallest of the different types of equations. So let's unpack in this video what is a linear equation and what characteristics do they have. And then throughout the next few videos, we'll talk about how we work with linear equations and how we solve linear equations. So in order to be a linear equation, and the key word here is linear, as opposed to some other type of equation, is that it's got to satisfy a certain number of criteria. So let's make a short little list here of some criteria we're going to be looking for to identify an equation as linear versus what's called nonlinear. So the first criteria, at least for now, is that we can have only one variable. All right, now that's a little misleading. What I mean when I say that is not literally one, like x, for example, in the whole equation. What I mean is one type of variable, meaning only x's or only y's or only k's. You can have 50 x's, that's not the issue, but the point is that they can only be x's. You can't have x's and y's. Now, it turns out even when you're talking about linear equations, there are some types of linear equations that have two variables that we'll study later in the course. But for now, we're going to make sure that there's only one type of variable for the moment. All right, number two, second criteria is that the variable's exponent must be one. So you can have x's, and that's totally fine. You can even have exponents. I'm not even saying you can't have exponents, but any variable that you have cannot be squared or cubed or whatnot. That would make it one of the other types of equations. So you can have x, but just make sure that it's to the first power. All right, number three, the last criteria is that there cannot be any variables in the denominator. You can have fractions, that's fine. We have fractions all the time, but just if you have a fraction, make sure any variables that you have are appearing in the numerator and not in the denominator. So as long as you satisfy these three criteria, then you have a linear equation. So a very common question is they'll give you just a list of different equations and they'll ask you, is this linear or is this not? Let's try a few. I'll quiz us here. Let's say we had 8 minus x over 2 equal to 5. And I want to know, is this considered linear? Well, I've got one variable, so that's good. I've got one variable, only x's. I'm going to look at this variable's exponent. The exponent for this variable is 1, so that's a bonus. Now I've got a fraction that worries me a little bit because I know something about you can't have something with fractions. You can have fractions, you just have to make sure that the x is not in the denominator, and it's not. So this one is a yes. This is a linear equation in one variable. All right, how about this one? 7 equals x minus 3 squared divided by 4. One variable, that's good. I only have x's. And again, let me reiterate something I said earlier. Even if you had an x on the left-hand side, even that would be okay. You can even have an x on the left-hand side. You just can't have an x and a y or a z or some other variable. So that's fine. But it's certainly fine the way that it is. All right, well, now I see an exponent. This worries me a little bit. There's something squared. And I said something about something couldn't be squared or cubed or whatever. But actually, exponents are fine. You can have exponents. Just the x cannot be squared or cubed. So 3 squared is 9. So that's totally fine. And lastly, I do see a fraction, but there's no variables in the denominator. So again, we're good to go. This is a yes. This is a linear equation. All right, here's our next one. 1 minus 1 over 2x equal to 10. So here I see this is not going to work because I've got a variable, one variable, that's a good thing. Exponent of 1, that's a good thing. But the variable is where? The variable is in the denominator, which we can't have. So unfortunately, this is a no. This equation is not linear. So the word we would use is we would say that it's non-linear. That's the word we would use. Now, later in the course, we'll actually have different words for different types of nonlinear equations. Why is it nonlinear? Is it nonlinear because it's a quadratic equation? Is it nonlinear because it's a rational equation or cubic equation or something like that? But for now, we'll just say nonlinear. All right, here's our last example. We have x plus 9 equals 2 minus y squared. And I see right off the bat, this one's a no. This one's actually a no for a variety of reasons. So you tell me, what are the reasons this is not linear? One is because there's more than one variable. You have x's and y's. And another reason is, even if you didn't have this x and it was just a y, it still would not be linear because this y is being squared and you can't have that either. So for a variety of reasons, this equation is not linear, or again, we would say non-linear. So anyway, hopefully that helps you better understand what's a linear equation and what's a non-linear equation.